Ensure that correct spinal protocol is followed while working with the patient. Measure the vertical distance from the top of the patient's shoulder to the tip of the chin. You can also estimate the height with your fingers. The measurement corresponds to the height of the device. If the patient's measurements fall between two consecutive sizes, apply the smaller size first. Additionally, measure around the patient's neck. This measurement corresponds to the size circumference of the device. Proper sizing is critical to achieve optimal immobilization. For supine application, ensure that correct spinal protocol is followed. Starting with the back piece, check that the arrow on the panel is pointing up. Push the back piece into the bed, slide it under the patient's neck, and center it. Note: long hair should be placed outside of the back piece. Apply the front piece with the chin secured in the recess and center it to ensure neutral alignment. The front arrow should point upward. The front piece overlaps the back piece to ensure effective immobilization. Apply the hook and loop straps on both sides. Tighten straps alternately to an equal length on both sides. Excess may be trimmed. Device application must be secure to ensure proper fit, maintain alignment, and correctly support the chin. The plastisote material can be trimmed or heat molded as necessary, depending on the patient's anatomy. Ensure that all edges are rounded off smoothly. When removing the device, ensure that correct spinal protocol is followed. Undo the straps, remove the front piece, and slide the back piece out from behind the head. To clean, wipe with a damp cloth and mild soap. Air dry. Note: do not machine wash, tumble dry, iron, bleach, or wash with fabric softener. Avoid contact with salt water or chlorinated water. In case of contact, rinse with fresh water and air dry.